Hey guys, it's Dee Bell here on Kev's View. On today's show, we'd like to welcome back Mel.
Hey, great to be back. Hey guys, what's
Thanks
up?
Thanks for coming back.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Last time Kev told me you were here, you guys had an awesome interview that I have yet to see, but I heard all good things about it. How was that feel?
Definitely. It was great, man. The interview was like a great stepping stone for me. You know what I mean? He asked me some questions that I already was asking myself and already knew the answers to, and he asked me some questions that I didn't know. It was just like everything about it was great. It was a great vibe, great time.
So what have you been up to since the interview?
A lot, writing different music and like whole different genres, like trying to piece myself into different genres of like rap, like hardcore rap. You got the more mellow rap, you got underground rap, bars rap. I just been writing to like every beat possible, trying to basically find it to where I get a perfect sound of what's going to push me, and basically just trying to choose out music like for my EP and my mixtapes. I got enough music, but just trying to choose which one should go where and which one I should do a video to, which one should I promote the most. So it's like a lot of work I've been doing since then.
So sounds like you're trying to create a storyline.
Yeah.
Right?
Basically.
Okay. You said now the mixtape is coming out, or are you working on the EP?
Mixtape coming out soon. I don't have no more songs to put on it. I just have to order them, put them in order, and then give a release date and just wait on it.
How soon?
Soon as in probably before the year's up. Definitely.
Okay. But that's soon enough because we only have a few more months.
Yeah.
Okay. So I know you're going to perform two songs for us today.
Yeah.
What's the first song?
The first song is Been Plotting.
Been Plotting?
Yeah.
What's that about? I know we're going to hear it, but like, give me a little intro.
It's basically all in the name. It speaks for itself. It's just a song about like the regular life, your regular day going on, and how people, you think they're your friends, even down to females, family, whatever it is, for anybody could relate to it. It's just people plot on you. People want to see your downfall.
Mm-hmm.
Some people, not everybody wants to see you.
Not everybody's for you.
Yeah,
that's
definitely
true.
So it just was basically something that I sat there and thought it was a great topic to write about and make a song. So,
were you going through something like specific during that time, or just general?
Not something specific. It just was like general speaking and me from the outside and seeing different situations. And who knows, the same situation could happen to me, or anything could happen.
People. Oh, it has happened to me several times. So I'm looking forward to hearing it and seeing the performance.
Yeah, definitely. Thank you.
Thank you. Is that we're going to do that now, right?
Yep.
The first song, We Plotting. Yeah. Check it out, y'all.
Been plotting, I can tell these niggas been plotting. Instagram, Facebook, watching in their head what I'm copping. At the party, rose, hey, popping. Man, I swear these niggas been plotting, cause these niggas been plotting. I can tell these niggas been plotting. Instagram, Facebook, watching in their head what I'm copping. At the party, rose, hey, popping. Man, I swear these niggas been plotting, cause these niggas been plotting. I can tell these niggas been plotting. Instagram, Facebook, watching in their head what I'm copping. At the party, rose, hey, popping. Man, I swear these niggas been plotting. They been plotting, so I stay with that thing. I used to drive the Chevy, now I'm riding in the range. And my neck so gold, it's like butter on my chain. And these bitches on my dick, is they ain't trying to take the train. Niggas getting money, so don't get up out your lane. They plotting on the nigga, cause I'm stepping to the fame. If I don't get it by myself, I'ma get it with my gang. And I still rock uptowns with them ball man. It's the same old nigga from the same old hood. Running with the felons, that ain't up to no good. And free my fucking brothers, I'd free them if I could. Try to throw the mails down, I wish a nigga would. Tie a nigga to a tree, leave him hanging in the woods. Roll a nigga up, put him in the backwood. Gang smoking on the op, straight up out the backwood. And the fiends still coming on you if they crack good. Niggas want your boy 6 feet in the dirt. They want me on the chain, niggas want me on the shirt. Cause they hating what I got, wanna see a nigga murk. Plying on my downfall, niggas wishing for the worst. Been plotting, I can tell these niggas been plotting. Instagram, Facebook, watching, and they hear what I'm copping. At the party, rose popping. Man, I swear these niggas been plotting, cause these niggas been plotting. I can tell these niggas been plotting. Instagram, Facebook, watching, and they hear what I'm copping. At the party, rose popping. Man, I swear these niggas been plotting, cause these niggas been plotting. I can tell these niggas been plotting. Instagram, Facebook, watching, and they hear what I'm copping. At the party, rose popping. Man, I swear these niggas been plotting. Niggas wanna take my life. Niggas wanna fuck my wife. Niggas want it all, dog. I done seen it all, dog. Coming strapped up, never roll, dog. Ride for my niggas, that's the bro code. Keep them on the block with the grip, get my little niggas cocoa. Always keep the pole, dog. Cause we blow a nigga no homo. Cause we blow a nigga no homo. Hard been cold since niggas took ski. And niggas better ride if a nigga take me. I'ma knock on the door and ask mama for the key. And throw a couple killers in that all black V. I swear, I'm all about the money. I swear, and they can take it from me, I swear. And these niggas don't care. I can see it in their eyes when they stare. I see it in their eyes when they stare. Cause the street's still watching. I got a couple friends, they plotting. I'm still in the field, no cotton. And niggas looking at my pockets. 4/5 cocking. I'm Jimmy Neutron with the rocket. Been plotting. I can tell these niggas been plotting. Instagram, Facebook, watching, and they hear what I'm copping. At the party, rose popping. Man, I swear these niggas been plotting. Cause these niggas been plotting. I can tell these niggas been plotting. Instagram, Facebook, watching, and they hear what I'm copping. At the party, rose popping. Man, I swear these niggas been plotting. Cause these niggas been plotting. I can tell these niggas been plotting. Instagram, Facebook, watching, and they hear what I'm copping. At the party, rose popping. Man, I swear these niggas been plotting.
I think there's a lot of stuff I'm wondering. How much is it fabrication, or, and how much of it is like real life stuff?
Everything I said was real life. Everything I said, if it wasn't a situation I went through, or it was a situation I seen, or a situation a friend went through, everything, nothing was made up.
No, I'm like, how you look young. How old are you? That's a lot for a how old are you?
Yeah, I'm 20.
20 years old to go through.
Yeah, and then it's like from young and up, like just growing up, it's like certain things I've seen, and it's basically, I'm speaking basically from my point of view and just speaking for everybody. If I say in a song and it's something I actually didn't do, or whatever case may be, it's me speaking in general for everybody.
Gotcha.
Because I'm the one that's rapping over the beat, so.
Now, you mentioned, there was a line there about your wife. Are you married?
Nah.
That's crazy. I was like, I'm 20 years old, y'all.
Nah.
All right. I want to hear the second song. What's that about?
The second song is We Lit. That song is basically the brighter song, basically.
Yeah, because that was a little heavy.
Yeah, it's the brighter song. It's basically saying it's like a dream. It's like a dream come true with everything. It's like me being in a dream, basically saying what I will have, what I do have, basically the better part of it. Me, my friends, my family, just the best of it, us being lit.
All right. I'm excited to hear it. Check it out, y'all. We Lit. We lit.
My niggas relate.
your money, no room for the man. Coming through your window like rum, man. This ride don't stop to the grunge, yeah. This shine don't stop to the sun, yeah. Don't look at the price tag, and the ring on like Floyd with the right jack. Baby, see the love, I think I might bag. Slide through, ride through on a nice jack. I run through the booth like easy pass. Need a rib in the woods, see breezy pass. Got ice, got cream, need cheesy cash. And I need cash money, that wheezy cash. Wanna roll it with diamonds inside. Gripping the five and the five. Wanna Grammy, I'm trying to survive. Put all of the drama aside. All of the fans, 12 of all of the fans. Singing my song on the gram, we're going from the brand. Roll up a pound, pop a zen. Don't freak it, I feel like a man. That was the plan, let my dose out of the can. Let my dose out of the can, that was the plan. Get my dose out of the can, get my dose out of the can. My knees be lit, show me stacks in the whip. Backpack stacks with the bricks, my knees be lit. 100 band cash with the lick, 100 mil stacks for the brick. My knees be lit, 1500 cash for the kicks. 1500 cash for the kicks, my knees be lit. House money cash for the whip, house money cash for the whip. All of my niggas inside, all of my bitches inside, sippin' and living the life. It all started from the poppy, had work drip down by the hockeys. Till the little niggas start moving sloppy, little hot man, the cops tryna lock me. These models ain't fucking that, I get money, my sandals got buckles now. I'ma laugh in your face, you a fucking clown. And designer, we come through your fucking town. These old niggas thinking they youngins, they feel like they Benjamin Button. I'm for what if the techies start dumping, he blow off the top of your muffin.
Excellent. Like, I think I like that one better than the first one. I definitely see this song being played on the radio, me jamming it, like, in the club scene.
Thank you. That was lit. Thank you. Literally.
I
appreciate it. Thank you.
Definitely keep up the good work, Mel. Like, you have something, so definitely don't give up.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
What is next for you?
Basically, next is pushing everything and promoting everything. I took time out of actually having patience and not just throwing something out when I know, like, say if it's a hit song, not throwing it out and not getting the attention that it's supposed to get. So basically it's promote and push the songs that's not trying to say no song you should have should be a song that you're not comfortable with.
Right.
So basically push the songs that's are the regular songs or at basically the bottom of your charts.
Mm-hmm.
Push those first, see what those could get you, and then you focus on the music that you know is going to get you to the top of the pedestal.
Well, you seem like you have it a plan. You have it all together.
Yeah,
okay, so
definitely.
Just keep growing, man. I'm definitely looking out for...
Thank you. I appreciate it.
You're welcome. Definitely. Thanks for coming. I have a next artist that I'm about to... What's up, Doe? You good? You chilling over here?
Good.
Right? Literally, though.
Appreciate it, man.
What did you really think about it? Because I think you've been in this game longer than he has.
A little bit, but you like the second song. I like the first song.
No. I really did like tomatoes, tomatoes.
You know what I'm saying? There's 8 billion people out there.
But join us again, Mel. Like, you definitely have something. Definitely keep it going. Don't give up. Okay.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
All right.
Thank you for having me here.
Thank you for coming again. Check him out. Before we go, can you tell the people where they can find you?
You can find me on Instagram at, I'm going to have to spell this out for you, at Nuski Mel, which is NUSKI_MEL. And then you can find me on Facebook as the same thing, no underscore, NUSKIMEL. And let's see. All the Snapchat and
don't it's already that. There.
Yeah, that's all already there.
Okay, so check it out. Check him out, guys. Okay, up next we have the Business Spotlight segment featuring myself, D Bell, and interviewing Sabine's Hallway Natural Hair Salon. So check that out.
Don't touch my hair when it's the fillings I wear. Don't touch my soul.
Hey guys, it's Dee Bell with the Business Spotlight, and today we have a special treat for you. As you can see, I'm not in the studio. I'm here joining Sabine Belvey of Sabine's Hallway Natural Hair Salon. Hey, girl.
Hi.
How you doing?
I'm great.
Thanks for joining, or having me, rather. Thanks for having me.
Sure.
Just have a seat. How you doing?
I am doing wonderful.
On this beautiful Sunday?
Yes.
I wanted to
happy
bring
Sunday.
Happy Sunday. Yes. You thank the Lord this morning?
I did, okay. In my own special way.
Oh, okay. Give thanks all day.
All day.
All right. I mean, I really want to say thanks for having us here with you today, and I really wanted to talk some hair, because hair is very important nowadays.
Yes, it is. Thank you for having me on the show. It's a pleasure.
Thank you. So, first and foremost, Sabine's Hallway. What inspired that name?
Well, so Sabine Hallway came from my actual hallway when I was doing hair in my apartment. So it was in the hallway, and then when I was looking for a commercial space, I found a space and it was small, just like the hallway. And when I was writing up my business plan, I was like, what am I going to call it? And my best friend was like, why don't you just call it Sabine's Hallway? And I was like, that may work. And the name sticked, and here we are.
It's working. I mean, you've gone far. Like, you've made it so far. This is definitely not the hallway, guys. It's where she started from, and that's big. How long have you been in business for?
So, right now, I've been in business. It's going to be 11 years come September.
11 years.
Yes.
That's awesome.
It is. I'm excited about it.
What makes it work? What made it work for you? Why do you think you've lasted 11 years and...
Well, the reason why I believe that I'm here thus far for 11 years is the consistency and the determination. Like, I am really determined to be successful, and my vision of success is having a legacy, being able to leave behind businesses for my cousins and my son and, you know, my nephews to manage for me. Being on to be able to be like, okay, you know what, Sabine's name is still living after I'm gone. Yeah.
Creating generational wealth.
Yes.
I love it.
Yes.
I love
exactly.
it. In 2017, we really need that.
Yes.
What inspires you to do hair? What made you fall in love with hair?
What made me fall in love with hair? I have been doing hair since I couldn't remember it. I've been doing hair since I was about 6, 7.
Wow.
I've been playing with hair. My aunt, matter of fact, was the person that really found out, like, you know what, she has a knack for it.
Really?
And that was about age 11, 12. And so I've been doing hair for profit since I was like 12 years old.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
So what advice do you have for someone who's looking, watching this interview right now and is inspired and wants, like, I want to be Sabine. You know, I want to have my own natural hair salon or a hair salon, period. What advice do you give them?
Well, the advice is that I would give someone that is interested in opening a salon or a business in general, just like, go for it. You believe in what you want, you should pretty much plan it out. Write down every idea and thoughts that you can come up with into your book, into your big plan book. You know, make sure it's big, because you're going to have lots of ideas and lots of thoughts, and I think that all should be put into a book, so that way you can go back and you can refer to it. Like, I go back to some of my books and I'm like, oh wow, I did that. I can scratch off, and that's always fun to be like, your scratch off
list. Right.
Yeah, things that you've been able to accomplish. And just never lose faith in yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You always have to believe in yourself. And no one else believes in you, you must believe in yourself. That is the most important. Because you'll have people that may say things to you that are like, you know, you shouldn't do this, you can't do that. They put their limitations on you. And you have to understand, you come from genius. You are limitless. You can do anything. And I had a teacher that said that to me one time, but you can do anything. I was like, really? I can? Oh, it's on. It's so on. And ever since then, I've been like, oh, I'm going to do this and do that. Sometimes it gets a little bit much because I add on a whole lot to my agenda. So being able to manage your time and organize yourself is very important. And you will learn to do that all within, you know,
Lifetime.
Yeah, within time, and you know, as you go through your journeys, you definitely have to do that. So that's my advice.
That's beautiful. So you said something very important earlier. You had someone who believed in you. So as a mentor, or do you mentor? Did somebody call? Can call you and say, Sabine, you know what? I saw your interview. I love everything. I love everything you're doing. Can I shadow you? Can you teach me? Are you open to teaching and being that person to someone else?
And that's a good question. So I was planning on being a mentor for an organization that I deal with and I've been dealing with for the past 6 years, which is called Children of Promise, that deals with children of the incarcerated. But with my schedule, like I was saying earlier, as far as me piling on things, it didn't pan out because I have a lot of things that I would like to do and would like to accomplish. And being a mentor is very important. You need to be able to be there for this person, to be there for this individual. And I found it would be unfair for me to be like, okay, I can do this, and I don't give you the quality time that you need. So right now, I am not mentoring anyone, you know, per se. However, a lot of people that are in my circle find me to be inspiring. So that's good for me. Yeah.
Okay.
And I love that. I want to be inspiring to others, and that's important to me. So that's why I live the life that I live and the way that I live it.
Mm-hmm.
It's so that way when people are looking at you, because you never know who you can inspire. You know, people I'm running in the park, and they're like, oh, you know, I saw you, and you know what, you got me going. I'm like,
wait, you run too?
Yes.
So when do you find the time?
And that's what I think about time. And yeah, you make your time for the things that you want and the things
that's
that you
true.
Enjoy that makes you happy. So I make time for running. So I found that I love running for the past 9 years now.
Wow.
So I entered races, and so I'm a marathon runner, so I'm a runner. Yeah, so I run long distance running, and I enjoy it. So
that's amazing.
Yeah.
It really is. I'm inspired. I feel like I'm not doing enough. you run marathons, you own a full-time salon, okay?
Yes.
Natural hair, right?
Yes.
Catering to natural hair?
Yes.
What other services do you guys offer?
So yes, so we are a natural hair salon, a full service natural hair salon. And we offer braiding services with extensions, without extensions, twists, lock maintenance, sister lock maintenance. We do color, we do treatments. So overall help of transitioning as well. The clients that are transitioning into natural hair care, and we do that for children as well as men and women.
That's awesome. So definitely natural hair, no perms over here.
Yeah, so we don't do any chemical services other than color.
That's awesome. Talking about, going back to, you mentioned writing a book, you know, your life is a big book. What is the next chapter of your life look like right now?
So yeah, so I am currently writing a book.
I can't.
So that's why my schedule is really packed. So I'm currently writing a book. I am also planning on partnering up with some family members and opening up a beauty supply store in the coming months. So that's really a big deal. I'm also launching my hair product, which is a hair growth line. And I am also working on, you know, doing another marathon. So I am running New York City Marathon in November.
Wow.
So I am doing
a lot.
Yeah.
You are. I just want you to find time for yourself too.
Oh, that's very, very important. And Sabine makes sure she does that. I do take monthly massages. I get my monthly massages done. Yeah, you know, mani, pedicure, you know, I take the day off. Self-care is very, very, very important. You know, since I'm also a health coach. So, yeah, I have to incorporate all those things into my life, the things that I tell my clients I should also be doing as well. So it's just not like, you know, I'm just talking the talk and I'm not walking it. So I tend to make sure that I'm doing that. Sometimes I slack, but, you know, for the most part,
you're on it. I really see that healthy living is important for you from inside and out. And I love that, that it's not only, you know, like you say, for yourself, you have to be an example for the other people that's in your life. And you lead by example, first and foremost. So that's really, I commend you.
Thank you.
You are really a breath of fresh air. Like, she is a salon owner. She runs marathons. She is a part of what Children of Promise, nonprofit organization. You have product lines coming out, beauty supply stores opening. You're an author, you know, that's wonderful. It's beautiful, really, to see a Black woman, you know, especially doing their thing and living in their truth and just inspiring others. So I thank you.
Thank you
for all that you're doing. You know, you're doing an amazing job in the community itself. Where can we find more information about you in the salon and everything, that upcoming projects that you're going to be doing?
Sure. So we do have a website, which is www.sabineshallway.com. And that's SabineshallWay, as well as all the social medias, which is Instagram, we're on Twitter, we're also on YouTube, and we're also on Facebook. So you can find us there.
Where's your salon located?
So we're at 450 Notion Avenue. We're at 450 Notion Avenue on the second floor in Bed-Stuy, Brooklyn, New York.
Did you know you had a natural hair salon right in Bed-Stuy? Now you know, okay? But you see all this tea being spilled right here at the bowl? Stay tuned, okay? Thanks for joining us here at Sabine's Hallway Natural Hair Salon, and thank you for having us here. And this is just awesome. You just gave me a whole lot of inspiration. Now I'm gonna go home and write my book. Signing out, D Bell. See you guys next time.
Don't touch my pride. They say the glory is all mine. Don't test my mouth. They say the truth is my sound. They don't understand what it means to me. But we chose to go where we meant to go. They don't understand what it means to me. But we chose to go where we meant to go. You know this.
We're back, and I have another dope artist for you here today. We have Doe in the building. Say hi, Doe.
What's going on? John Doe here. Doe World Music. What's up, everybody?
We're good. Thanks for coming.
What's up, Daphne? It's good to see you.
Likewise. I have a whole lot of questions for you, but first and foremost, how old are you?
34.
So you've been seasoned in this game. When did you start rapping and get into music?
Yeah, no.
I
know. I'm sorry. No.
How old were you when you first?
You know what? I've been doing music, a lover of music, all my life. So, okay. Going from writing to composing and arranging to actually vocalizing.
Mm-hmm.
It came as a process, and so I really can't say when it started. It just came together.
Okay. Yeah. I like that answer. Where are you from?
I am from Queens. Without
Queens in the building.
Greatest of all time.
Oh boy.
You know, 50 without.
We're not gonna do that right now.
Alright, we're not gonna do that right now.
Off camera.
But shout out to Queens. Right now I'm residing in Long Island though.
Okay. So you talked about composing. What genre of music do you cover? All? Are you mostly hip hop, rap?
I do it all. I don't. Doe World Music Group. We do not limit ourselves to one genre of music.
Okay.
When there, you know, so much music to be appreciated. You know, why keep it in a box?
I agree with you. I was going to ask you, what does hip hop means to you? But now more so, what does music mean to you? What is that?
Music is like acting.
Okay.
You know, and that's why artists are so appreciated, is because they can bring out emotions in people. Mm-hmm. We can bring out emotions in people. And that's why, you know, I don't call rappers rappers. I don't call singers singers. I call them artists. Just, you know, same with actors. They're artists, you know. And so, I just see music is everything.
It's artistry. I love it.
Yeah, absolutely.
I do feel the same, because music for me is very therapeutic. It can definitely transform your mood from happy, sad to crazy, maybe a little bit, depending on who you're listening to.
Exactly. Yeah.
So my next question for you, other than music, like, what else are you into?
Well, ladies, we have a company called Dough World Jewels, and if you look that up, it's the best jewelry.
What's it called again? Because I might have to check that out.
World Jewels. D-O-E World Jewels.
Now, is that where your pieces come from?
Dough World.
Dough World. Okay.
Yeah.
Being that you seasoned in this game, right, what personal advice would you give a up-and-coming new artist?
Don't let people who don't think or dream or have goals on the same level as you tell you what your limits are. Mm. You know, the friends that you hang closest with might be the ones holding you back. You just never know. You have a dream, be an individual and follow it. Don't look for your friends to follow your dream, and don't look for your family for support. You do it. If people want to help you, they're going to help you. But remember, first and foremost, is you. You are chasing this dream. Nobody's chasing it for you.
That's very sound advice. Like, I couldn't have said it any better. You know, you get tainted, you know, through experiences, but focus on what your goal are.
Exactly.
What your goal is. Exactly. Yes. Okay. What's in your playlist? What kind of music? I know you do everything, but what's in your playlist?
Well, as rugged as I might come across, I keep a R&B playlist. I love R&B.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
And there's a lot of good R&B out there. You just have to still search and find it. But I listen to a lot of new. I keep up on new music as much as possible. Follow new artists, because art is beautiful. Classics are beautiful, but there's new art out there to be appreciated, and so I look to be touched all the time. And not that's just so you asking me to answer your question.
Mm-hmm.
What's in my playlist? I have some R&B in my playlist. Some new artists I don't even know if you're familiar with.
No, you gotta put me on, man. I'm a sucker for R&B music.
You know Molly music, right?
I do know Molly music.
Okay, so he's new and he's hot. Janae Okia.
Mm-hmm.
She's awesome. Have you heard While We're Young?
No.
Okay, well, there's your homework assignment, While We're Young.
But who's that by?
Janae.
Okay, yeah. I'll check it out. While We're Young.
Hip-hop artists. Jay's back in the...
He's back, all right.
Yeah, he's back all the way. He's back. He never really left, but
that's
true. But he came back hard, and I have his album in on the reserve. And who else can I tell you right now? Oh,
da-na-na.
Drake.
Everybody has Drake on their playlist.
Sometimes I don't want it to.
Why you don't want to admit it?
Drake.
What's wrong with Drake?
There's nothing wrong with Drake.
Okay.
Drake makes great music.
He does. But why Drake? All right, we're going to talk about that later. So who's your top five artists? Favorite of all time.
R&B, rap, and all that?
All of it.
Wow. I'm going to have to go with hip-hop. I can't. I have a top five.
Oh.
But R&B,
mm-hmm.
I can't.
Help me out here.
I have a top five. You always have to have a top five. I can't. It's like saying what's my favorite topping on pizza.
I have
a top five.
That's great. Okay, so give me top five of each category. Hip-hop, R&B.
Jay-Z.
Uh-huh.
Number one. R&B. Pink. Tink is up there right now. Tink is up there right now.
Tink is up there?
Tink is up right there.
What's new? Has he come out with anything new recently?
Not Tank.
Tink. Okay, I don't know who that is. I'm sorry.
Little Tink?
No.
I'm gonna have to make a playlist for her to look
Please
up.
Please do. So I know we have a lot of stuff going on right now, but you performing for us today, right?
Definitely.
Yeah. What songs?
I'm gonna perform 7 1/4, mm-hmm. which is when you got money. 7 1/4.
7 1/4. What's that about?
7 1/4. You got money, and we having fun. We relaxing. Yeah, we doing it. Everyone is a come up song. The 7 1/4 is like come up, but now you got a little money, got a little change behind you. For the Love of It is why it's hip hop. Why am I doing it? You know, I love getting money.
Mm-hmm.
Don't get it wrong. Money is why we're all here. But I do it because I love what I do.
Should not be the root.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
Got you.
Yeah. So I'm also going to perform What Am I, which is kind of how I feel about mm-hmm. myself in the rap game, because it's really hard to, after you listen to my music, how would you, what is he?
I was asking myself that question before. No.
So, and the last song I'm going to do is Hold It Down.
Okay, so you're doing 3 songs for us today. 4. Yay. All right. So let's jump right into it. What songs first?
I think 7 1/4.
7 1/4. I'm ready. I want to hear this.
All right.
You better go hard or go home.
That's Daphne for
you. All right.
All right, let's go. Yeah. 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 7 1/4, got a house on the water. Headed to New York on the way back from Florida. Got the re-up, got a girl with a D-cup. Just a feature. Yeah, yeah. I cripple tracks, body dudes, run and shoot, run the booth. Got a sunroof where the sun come through. Can't see why they run with you. Did the game change? I was born. Predicted I'd make it like Notre Dame. Smoke that, pass that. Rhyme flow, hazmat. You blast first, I blast back. Know what it takes to be the best. It's been a couple days and I still ain't rest. Ain't no sleep till I see success. Timing. Put long hours into the grinding. You won't make if you don't take no risk. That's why half y'all boys ain't built for this. Lit the wrist, push the ignition. Stay on point. Chef the kitchen, got an A3. All white speakers blowing Jay-Z. I make the money, but the money don't make me. Now you're mad, but I'm only what you made me. I give these boys another reason just to hate me. Stay with Cake C, get the cheddar B. Under palm trees, me and Beverly. Better believe, it's a new era. Smoke, will I ask you redder? Hold up, I'm hotter than the heat rock. I'm hotter than a teapot. Do it to it with my tongue on a G-spot. Or every time at the peace job. 7 1/4, got a house on the water. Headed to New York on the way back from Florida. Got the V-up, got a girl with a D-cup. Just a feature, about to turn the streets out. All day I dance, cause I get them bands. All day I dance, cause I get them bands. All day I dance, cause I get them bands. All day I dance, cause I get them bands now. Woo! Don't worry, baby. When they ask me why I do it, I do it for the love of it. I do it for the love of it. Wah.
I do it for the love of it.
I assault the wrist, eat the track. Been broke, I ain't going back. That's a fact, bouncing in my lap. Shorty love the track, like the streets. Love the crack. And I'm moving packs. It ain't where you from, it's where you at. I'm still a dog, still a Mac. Dent you on the instrumental, kill you with the pen and pencil. Thug and rugged kid, do it for the love of it.
Ask me why I do it, man. Ask me why I do it, man. I do it for the love of it. Ask me why I do it, man. Yeah. Block become jungle, jungle now block. Big dreams, live in the mansion, doing things you can't imagine. Every verse, I fill it with passion. No, you can't, cause you like the cancer. Here I stand, hip hop the answer. John Doe the antidote. Rolling smoke, selling records by the boat. Do the tour off the coast. Costa Rica like the beat, Africa, this the feature. And at the present, here I stand, still a man, highly requested. Doing numbers you never expected. Sleeping giant, now awake, resurrected. Conscious, I walk with monsters every day. Where you stand is where you lay. I do this with an urgency, like something got a purge in me. But they know I did it purposely. I captured a moment, I'm in it, I own it. City blocks the beat, it moves me. It's gonna take a city to move me. My life a movie, I ain't acting. Closed caption, HD, I deliver. Summer, spring, the fall of the winter. Flood the streets, I bring it back to the beats. And backseat, and back to the flow. Homicide vehicular, Mr. Doe, how you do it? Dirty Ruth is right for many. Mentally, I remember how it used to be. Smoking weed with seeds, best believe now we five star. Check the sleeve, and technically they check for me. Highly aggressive, acoustic, eclectic, the rhymes is a weapon. See through the lies, see through the deception. I grind hard the same clothes that I slept in. Overdue, body shots, body you. Townhouse with the ocean view. Make money, murder music, for the love of it. For the love of it. Ask me why I do it, man. I do it for the love of it. For the love of it. For the love of it. Ask me why I do it. Yeah, I do it for the love of it. For the love of it. Ask me why I do it, man. Ask me why I do it, yeah. Love of it. 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 John Doe, baby. John Doe, baby.
No, like, you had me tapping my feet, you know? Club bangers. Like,
that's what we do.
That's
what we do. Don't whirl, baby. Don't whirl.
All right.
Don't whirl.
I know that was a really super dope and energetic performance you just gave us here. So I'm going to let you breathe a little, wipe the sweat off. And I want you guys to check out the new Artist Corner with DJ Kev and MC Mel.
Tell me who you are.
Hey, what's up? My name is Murder Mel, young up-and-coming artist from Brooklyn, New York, downtown Brooklyn to be exact, Gowanus Projects. 20 years old, just trying to live up to the dream.
Okay. So what type of music do you, genre of music do you perform?
Hip-hop, basically. Hip-hop and sometimes a little bit of R&B. So I can say both hip-hop and R&B.
Can you relate to any artists out there?
It's like bits and parts, so I can relate to many artists. I would say like older artists, like not super duper old, but like not this new generation, like artists around my age. Cause I feel like I have like more, not to say I'm better than anybody before this league, but feel me, cause I've been rapping since I was about 8-9 years old. So I already know what to do. I already know different type of music. I didn't just start, so I'm not. I could give you this type of music that's in this generation today, but I still can bring it back to regular MC, as a regular MC, just straight bars and straight rap. Not trying to really be such a rock star, you know, how this new music goes.
So when you say relate to other artists, older artists, this question comes to mind. Name your top five greatest artists of all time. Don't have to be rapper. It be just artists, period.
I say Jay-Z, Biggie, Jada. I gotta put Lil Wayne in it for me personally. Last but not least, I'd probably say Nas. From me, because these is like people for me. I listen to a lot of other music, and I don't even listen to these rappers on a daily. These rappers that I'm talking about right now. But this is who I grew up to. This is who I know lyrically and music wise, and they could, they're the best rappers of all time to me. They can give you a club banger. They can give you straight bars. They can give you a great feature. They can give you like anything in any category. So that's what make them the best to me. They conquered their time periods at their time. So that's what make them the best to me.
Three out of those five,
that's a little bit easier for me. I say Jada, Jay-Z, and Big. That being them three, singling it down to them three, is because of what they say with him. They like, oh, he didn't even drop many albums. There's so many people that could be better than him. Oh, he never did the same. He was above his time. And for the little time that he was out there, he did what he had to do. He took over. He put the East Coast, put New York, put Brooklyn back on the map to where it's supposed to be. And he did that with Jay-Z followed up. And he just kept it that all three of them was New York rappers. And he just kept it going. And he just made it to where Brooklyn could, and New York, I can say, because Jada from Yonkers, I can say New York, just real rap. They give you all types of rap. If you want to sit there and really be mellow and get in your bag, they can give you that type of rap. And if you want to really put it to politics, they can give you that too. If you want to bring it to a club banger where you just want to get drunk and go to the club, they can bring you that too. They can bring you every type of rap. That's what makes them do the best.
One.
Jay-Z.
Wow.
Jay-Z, this one for me is kind of easy. I'll wait for this question. I'll argue about this all day, like, with everybody. I say him because he just gives you everything. He gives you everything, like every single thing. You can go from Big Pimpin' when he was giving you the club bangers. You can go from his new album, 444, where he giving you, where he coming from, when he coming at politics and coming, giving you basically the manual and a rubric to be a millionaire. Like, he can give you anything. That for a rapper to be able to give you the basically the steps to become a millionaire and where the game is going wrong and really tell you what's going wrong, for somebody to really do that, that really just put the icing on the cake for me to where I know where Jay-Z was the best. He always was my number one artist. But once that album came out, I just knew over it. He said it himself, he could sell you $1 million worth of drink for $9.99. Like, he's ridiculous. Like, that's just a big inspiration. I listen to every song and I really run it back and run it back and run it back. And I see, I listen to something else differently every time. I listen to this, I pay attention to the beginning, pay attention to what he's saying. I really take everything we say and we just do it.
Okay, so while we're on this topic, you gave me four New York artists and you gave me one country dude. What about Lil Wayne? You put in that category. Why you put him in that category with those?
He came from up and then he stood so steady for so many years. Like, from when he was a hot boy to where it was just Cash Money and Number Birdman, and then to where he made it to where it was Young Money. And when they put it together, like, he just conquered and he was the number one rapper. Like, when Jay-Z started to fall back, whatever the case may be, it really started to get into business and signing artists. He was the number one rapper for so long. Every number one hits, number one albums, mixtapes, everything, like, features, everything he touched was just going number one, going Billboard 100, going top 10. It's just, like, lyrically. And what I like about Wayne the most is he raps the way I rap. Like, if I give you 16 or if I give you a song that's just straight rapping, ain't really bitches on my dick is that R&B song or a hip hop trying to vibe through song, I give you a straight bars, that's how I will rap. And which I mean, what I mean by that is straight punchlines. Like out of 16 bars, he gonna give you at least 8, 9, or 10 punchlines. And that's what I try to give every time. Cause after, when you growing up rapping, you know that you rap, you start off just trying to make words rhyme. Then after a while, after you get into it, you gotta do something different. You can't stay the same. So what you do is you try to make something better. You try to up your vocabulary. You try to get punchlines in there and metaphors. And then he just gives you everything. He make you think. There's certain times I listen to his music where I knew the song for 5 years. And 5 years later, I noticed what he said. And I be like, oh my God. It's like, I could put him there, like, definitely. Like, some, it's people like 50 and Fab that I could put, I could say they top 10. And I always even think about putting 50 up there, but I gotta put Wayne. But New York, the reason why the first four is New York, because it's just real rap. A lot of real rap comes from New York. Like down south, they got good beats, they got good flow, they got good party songs, good club songs. But New York is like, it's the city, it's just mixed with everything. Like, and coming up with so many artists in New York that they know that they gotta make songs for that somebody down south is gonna be able to bump to. Somebody out of the country, somebody here, there, like, it just, they know what to do.
So when it comes to your music, do you give trap music, you give love songs, what's the flow with your music?
For my music is like everything like that. I learned that you gotta make music for everybody. Like, I can't even sit there and say I know how to make one type of music better than another, because when I start to think that, and then I make another song, I start to go towards that path and think, oh, I make this type of music. Like, I make trap music better than an R&B song. I make trap music better than a love song. Every song I try to give is just like a different style. For me, it's just like, for me, my what I could say, primary will be like just basic rap, like straight bars, MC, regular hip hop rap. But after that, I could say I could trap, I could make trap and drill music, I could make love songs, I could make any type of song. That's with me being, I don't even consider myself as just like a rapper. I consider myself as an artist, an all around artist. I could make any type of song, I could get on any type of feature, any type of beat, any type. It's just I've been rapping for so long that I know different, I've been through different time periods. So why I know I can bring it back to how the beats was back in the days where you could dance to them. I can bring it to nowadays where it's sort of the rock star, the mumble rap, but I wouldn't even like mumble rap, but anything I do, I just adapt to it. But I truly come back to my real self after a while. I mean, I just give whatever I can to basically get myself out there.
Who's in your playlist?
My playlist. I got Meek Mill. I got Jay-Z. I got Jada. I got a little bit of 50 Cent. I got A Boogie, Don Q, Rich Homie Quan, Young Thug, Money Man. I got a couple people in my playlist. Yeah. Who else I can think of? Fab. Let's go on.
I'm darn it.
Yeah, it needs to work, okay. We're going to get mail the right for you.
You got me? All right. No. Like, you have so much energy, so much stage presence. Like, look at you.
I know.
It's really, really high energy in here, y'all. What are some future projects you working on? Because I definitely need some more.
We have, right now, I have to be honest with you guys. We took everything off the internet right now. We you know, this record company is new, and we are doing big things. So, okay. As you can see, we have hot music for you. We are working with other artists. We are going to put it all out for you. Hot videos, hot music. You're going to go to the website. You're going to get it. And we're going to give it to you.
All right. Where can the people find you? What's your Instagram?
Well, like I just said.
I mean, you took everything off the internet.
We took everything off the internet. So if you find some John Doe, J-O-N-D-O-E, it's old stuff.
Okay.
And, you know, it'll say, you know, when it was posted. So it's old stuff. The new stuff, the stuff that you want to hear.
Okay, so he's going to let us know where we can find it. And we're going to share with you guys. Come join me on the stage, y'all. Mel. Thank you again for joining us. Mel, you was dope. You know, appreciate I want you to it, keep on going. It. You know, you're 20 years old. There's so much more.
Thank you. I appreciate you know? It. I appreciate it. Thank you for having me here.
Thank you. Before we go, let the people know where they can find you again on social media.
You can find me on Instagram, Nuski Mel. You can find me on Instagram, Nuski Mel, NUSKI_MEL. You can find me on Facebook, same thing, Nuski Mel. No underscores, just space.
No underscore, just space. Dull.
Well, like I told everybody earlier, we took everything down. So you cannot find me right now, temporarily, but do not worry. We will find you.
Just be sure to subscribe to the YouTube channel, Kev's View TV show, so you'll get all the updates on these artists here. So you'll see what their future projects are, and where you can find, especially if you're interested in Doe. Be sure to follow me, Bell_Beauty718 on Instagram, Daphne Bellevue on Facebook, and the show itself is Kev's View TV show on Facebook. So check it out, okay? Thanks for joining us. Been it's a wrap.
I can tell you guys been plotting. Instagram, Facebook, watching in the head what I'm copping. At the party, rose, hey, popping. Man, I swear these niggas been plotting, cause these niggas been plotting. I can tell these niggas been plotting. Instagram, Facebook, watching in the head what I'm copping. At the party, rose, hey, popping. Man, I swear these niggas been plotting, cause these niggas been plotting. I can tell these niggas been plotting. Instagram, Facebook, watching in the head what I'm copping. At the party, rose, hey, popping. Man, I swear these niggas been plotting. They been plotting, so I stay with that thing. I used to drive the Chevy, now I'm riding in the range. And my neck so gold, it's like butter on my chain. And these bitches on my dick is staying, trying to take the train. Niggas getting money, so don't get up out your lane. They plotting on the nigga, cause I'm stepping towards the fame. If I don't get it by myself, I'ma get it with my gang. And I still rock uptowns with them ball man. It's the same old nigga from the same old hood. Running with the felons that ain't up to no good.